how can you create a calculator with Integromat where you just input the weight, height, and metric, or anything that you need for the formula. Then you press enter and you get the output like this. Your BMI is 24.69 and the category is normal. If you want to learn how to set this up yourself, then keep watching this video. My name is Manuel and I'm the founder of techflow.ai. In this video, I will show you exactly how you can make calculations with Integromat, which you can use for any kind of integrations. So you can send data to Integromat from any kind of source, do the calculation inside of Integromat, and then pass back whatever value you want to pass back. And in this case, I'm using the BMI, which is calculated by the weight, the height, and then, of course, depending on the unit, if it's metric, which is used in most of the world, or if it's imperial, which is used in mainly in America. So I've set up or I've prepared a scenario for you already, where at the very beginning, we have a webhook, which you've already seen in my previous screen, where we have the URL, and then we send certain parameters. We send in the weight, in our example, 80, which is in kilogram. Then we send the height, which is in meters, so 1.8, and the unit is metric, because I'm in Europe, so I use metric for this example. But in the whole scenario, we also have a separate path with imperial. So you can make it fully dynamic. So in any case, like if the metric is or the value unit is imperial here, then it will go the other path and use the other formula because it's calculated slightly different for metric and imperial. So let's get into the actual formula. The formula for the BMI is weight divided by the height 2 times. And this is how I set it up in Integromat. And then it's using the value that you've passed in from the webhook. So in the webhook data that we get, these are the parameters that we have already seen here, which are at the top. We get them into Integromat and then we can use them further inside of our variable, inside of our formula. Then this is what we get as an output. It's 24.69 and then all these decimals here. And then we want to send it back into the browser. So I've prepared different return values which we could set up. So the first one is just simply sending the number back. So let's try this one out. It says your BMI and then it rounds the matrix to 2 decimals because of course I don't want to have like the full value like this one over here. That would be, I don't know, it's not interesting for me. So I want to cut off everything after the past 2 decimals. And how to do that, it's slightly tricky, it's like a little workaround. So we have to multiply this number by 100 first, so that would be 2469.13 whatever, and then we round it normally because the rounding function will always round it to full numbers, to integers. So it would round it to 2469. And then we divide it by 100 again, so we get back to our original number, which is 24.69. And that's how the rounding is done for a certain amount of decimals. If you want to have more decimals, then you could use 10,000, for example, but then you would also have to adapt this other value over here. So I will leave it to 100 for now because I just want 2 decimals. And if I run this one now, I've turned off the other pass. So this is just for testing. So when I run this one now, I can see your BMI is 24.69. So that is the first step and the easiest solution. You can return these values to wherever you want. You can update it in a Google Sheet or do whatever you want with this. Or for a chatbot, for example, that's very handy. If you want to do advanced calculations or other parameters, you can just pass values from your chatbot to Integromat. And then on Integromat, you're doing the calculation and then you pass it back into the chatbot and give out the result. Then the next would be the value including a category. So let's enable this route. And this is what you've already seen before. So we have a bunch of formulas in here with the range, the BMI range of what is counted as severely underweight, underweight, normal, overweight, obese, and so on. So I've already implemented these ones like the standard numbers for the BMI. And we're doing it with layering a bunch of if functions. So if the actual BMI that we got out from our formula is lower than 16, then it's severely underweight. And if it's not under 16, then we check the next if function. If it's between 16 and 18.4, then it's underweight. And then we continue to do this until we have covered all of the different categories available. So the next one is between 18.4 and 24.9. It's normal, 24.9 until 29.9 is overweight, and so on. You get the point, right? And then at the end, it's just else. So if it's not between 34.9 and 39.9, which means if it doesn't match any of the previous expressions, then it's definitely over the 39.9, and then it's morbidly obese. So at the very end, after the functions, I always put like these brackets and make sure that all gray brackets are closed, because this means that these ones are needed for our functions. So when there are ones that are not gray with a gray background anymore, then we're good to go. So I remove the false ones and keep the formula ones. And now if I run this again, I can get the category out of it. So over here we get the BMI category, and that is normal for 24.69, because that is in the range of this one here. Yeah, it's between 18.4 and 24.9. All right, so this also gives you possibility to do more with the number that you got out of your calculation. You can use this one, or if it's a specific number and not a number range, you can also use the switch function, which is quite handy for these use cases, and then give that back as value to whatever source you have or wherever you want to send that value, for example a chatbot. So next, what I've implemented here, which is also great for if you just want to display it on a browser, you can use HTML actually in the webhook response. So that is the structure to use. We have the doc type, HTML, header, and then the body, and then normal HTML tags. Make sure that if you're using HTML tags, like the new lines won't work anymore if you just type them inside the editor. So you have to actually use br for new lines. And then we have exactly the same thing. I added some font size for styling and centered it, so that way it looks like you've already seen it at the very beginning. It will be centered and big, and here your BMI is 24.69 and BMI category is normal. I have set up the whole same thing for you in Imperial, so the calculation is slightly different, so it's the same in the middle, but then we also multiply everything with 703. And then how it works, you just have to set the unit to Imperial. So over here to Imperial, and then you have to change the weight and the height into Imperial units, and then you can just run it and it will give you back the BMI. So this is how you can create any kind of calculation within Integromat and return the value to wherever you want to have it. And in case you want to learn more how to use these kind of functions, for example, layering the if functions over here, or using advanced math functions and doing all these kind of things, then I recommend to you to check out my Integromat functions cheat sheet. You will find a link below the video in the description, which will walk you through all the available functions on Integromat and explain them and show you examples how to use them, and give you copy and paste ready functions that you can just paste into Integromat and they will transform into the function. You can just use them right away. So that is super helpful, and I really recommend to check this out, because it helps so much in speeding up the learning progress, and they are so helpful, as you can see, for all kind of different things inside of Integromat. Thank you very much for watching.